So this is the power rating of some of the common electrical appliances. You must have seen that the common electrical appliances such as your electric bulb or fan, on its surface the power and the voltage will be written, will be marked. So this is what we say, the rating of the power or the power rating, and also this is known as voltage power rating. Suppose, say for example, a bulb is marked as 100 watt and 220 volt. Suppose this is marked on the surface of a bulb. What is the meaning of that? And why this is marked? Can you tell me? What is the reason behind that? So when a bulb is marked or any electrical appliance is marked in this manner, what is the meaning of that? If suppose a bulb is marked as 100 watt, 220 volt, it means that when the bulb is lighted on 220 volt supply, the electrical power consumed by the bulb is 100 watt. Remember that. That means if the supply voltage, if the supply V will be 220 volt, then the power consumed by the appliance will be the rating power. That is your how much rating power? 100 watt. So this is the meaning of the power voltage rating. Again I repeat, when a bulb is marked as 100 watt, 220 volt, it means that when the bulb is lighted on 220 volt supply, then it consumes 100 watt of electrical power. Or on the other hand, we can define also, when the bulb is lighted on 220 volt supply, then 100 joule of electric energy is converted into light energy or heat energy in 1 second. Because in the case of the bulb, we are getting what? The electric energy convert into light energy and the heat energy. So in this way also we can write. And from this rating power and the voltage, we get two physical quantities. So two physical quantities can be calculated from the rating power and the voltage. What are these? Number one, the resistance of the appliance, or the resistance of the filament of the bulb. Whenever we are speaking about the bulb, simply we can find the resistance. And number two, we can find the safe limit of current which can flow through the appliance. That is your I. I stands for your what? Current, means the safe limit of current. Safe limit of current, I. And R stands for resistance. So when a bulb is marked as 100 watt, 220 volt, then two things we can find. Number one is resistance of the filament of the bulb, and number two, the safe limit of current. Now how can you find the resistance? Now from the expression we know that, see, P is equals to V square by R. You have known. So here what is given? P and V is given. We are going to find R. So therefore we can find R is equals to V square divided by P. That means the square of the voltage or the voltage rating divided by the power, which will give us the resistance of the filament of the bulb. Say for example, in this example we will find how much will be the resistance. Now see, here we are getting power is equal to how much? 100 watt, and voltage or the potential difference V is equal to how much? 220 volt. Now see, we are going to find the resistance. So therefore the resistance R is equals to what, you know, V square by P. V square means 220 whole square divided by P is your 100. So when you simplify it, then you will get 484 ohm. That means the resistance of the filament of bulb will be 484 ohm whenever a bulb is marked as 100 watt and 220 volt. So let's see, how can you find the safe limit of the current? So the safe limit of current can be found from the expression, you know, P is equals to V into I, isn't it? Therefore, I is equals to P by V. Now, P stands for power rating and V stands for voltage rating. So, the safe limit of current can be found by this expression, that is power rating divided by voltage rating. Let's see in this example how much will be the current. So here current will be I is equals to power rating is how much? 100 watt divided by voltage rating is how much? 220 volt. That is equals to here approximately 0.5 ampere. So the safe limit of current which can flow through the filament of the bulb is 0.5 ampere. So what is the meaning of safe limit of current? Safe limit of current means the bulb is withstand with a current of 0.5 ampere. If the current exceeds this value 0.5 ampere, then what happens? The bulb will be fused or maybe there will be some damage to the bulb. So this is the meaning of the safe limit of current, which means that the bulb is withstand up to a current of 0.5 ampere. If the current exceeds the safe limit of the current, then the bulb or the electrical appliance will damage. So this is the meaning of the safe limit of current. So let's see now, how can you calculate the electric energy consumed at the homes? We are using the different electrical appliances at the houses, you know, refrigerator, air conditioner, fan, electric bulb, etc. Lot of things we are using at the house. Now, how can you calculate the electric energy consumed by all these appliances at the home? This is the consumption of the electrical energy in the house or household consumption of electrical energy. Generally, students, remember that whenever we are using the different appliances at the house, the electric energy is consumed is calculated in the unit, that is kilowatt hour. Why? Because kilowatt hour is the commercial unit of electric energy, and this is the unit in which we pay the cost of electricity to the electric department. So therefore, we calculate the electric energy consumed by the different household appliance in the unit of kilowatt hour. Remember. So now see, how can you find the energy consumed by the appliance? We know that energy, electric energy, W is equals to, what you know, P into T means power into time, and the power, the SI unit of power is watt, the SI unit of time is second, so watt second is the SI unit of energy. Now, when this power is converted into kilowatt and time is converted into hour, then we get the electric energy in kilowatt hour. So in general, we find the electric energy in kilowatt hour. Remember that. So electric energy in kilowatt hour is equals to P in kilowatt into T in hour. So this is the formula to find the electric energy in kilowatt hour. Means the power has to be converted in kilowatt and time has to be converted in hour. Then only we can find the electric energy in kilowatt hour. Suppose if the power is not given in kilowatt, then how can you find? If suppose the power is given in watt, then we can write here P in watt into T in hour divided by 1000. So then we'll get the electric energy in kilowatt hour. So here also we'll get the electric energy in kilowatt hour. Understanding? Now, if the power is given in watt, then we write power in watt into time in hour divided by 1000. If suppose the power is not given, then we have to find the power. I have given you the different expression to find the power. Suppose one expression I am using. Suppose I am using, you know, P is equals to VI, isn't it? That means V in volt into I in ampere into T in hour divided by 1000. Then we'll find the electric energy W in kilowatt hour. So all these are the expressions which will help you to find the electric energy consumed at the house. And remember that the electric energy consumed at the house is calculated in the unit kilowatt hour. So kilowatt hour is the unit in which we pay the cost of electricity. So the electric bills and all which are we are giving, na? So this will be actually calculated in the unit of kilowatt hour. So say for example, I am giving one example for you. Say for example, a house is using a geyser of power 3 kilowatt. Suppose the power of the geyser is given how much? 3 kilowatt. And is used say 2 hours per day. How much it is? Time is given how much? 2 hours per day. Now we need to calculate the electric energy in a month of 30 days. So see now how I will find. So the electric energy, since it is given P is equals to 3 kilowatt, T is equals to 2 hours, already it is given in kilowatt hour. So now electric energy we will find per day initially. So electric energy per day W is equals to P into T simply. No need of getting this power in other form, because already it is given in kilowatt. This is already given in hour. So therefore that is equals to P is given 3 into T is given 2. So now how much is coming? 6 kilowatt hour. So therefore the electric energy consumed by the geyser in a day is how much? 6 kilowatt hour. Now suppose we are going to find the electric energy consumed by the geyser in a month of 30 days. So the energy consumed in a month, then W is equals to, 1 month is how many days? 30 days. So 6 kilowatt hour into 30. So how much will become now? Because in a day it is consuming 6 kilowatt hour. So we need to find in a month, means what? 30 days. So how much it is? 180 kilowatt hour. So the electric energy consumed by the geyser in a month is how much? 180 kilowatt hour. So this is the way how can you find the electric energy consumed by the electrical appliance. I have given one simple example, and then after this we can find the cost of the electricity. Suppose after that is given, the cost of electricity per unit is 5 rupees. Now you calculate the cost of electricity for 180 rupees, for 180 kilowatt hour, how much will be the, that will be your answer only. Okay, I hope you understood. Thank you.